At the end of my struggle. you for the day that you've given to us, for the beautiful day you've had to enjoy. We thank you for the many blessings that you bestow upon us each and every day. We thank you, Father, for each other, for our church family. We give you great honor and praise, Father, for bringing the church into existence. And we thank you that we can be included in that church. We thank your Son for allowing us to be washed of our sins because of his sacrifice, for giving himself for us. We pray, Father, that you'll be with those that are not here this evening. Bless them, Father. Be with them. We pray that they can join us soon. We ask that you be with the Lindorf family in the loss of their daughter. That you will bless them, Father, as only you can. Our hearts ache for them, Father. We just ask you to wrap your arms around them and just love them and give them peace. We pray, Father, that you'll be with all of our emergency workers. That you'll keep them safe as they continue to protect us and fight against the COVID virus. We know, Father, that eventually this has got to come to an end, and we just pray that it can come soon. But we know that your will be done, Father, in all things. Again, we thank you for the opportunity to gather here this evening and worship you and praises unto you and come to you through prayer. We pray that you'll be with Gentry as he leads us in the song service, be with Scott as he brings us a lesson. And we pray that we can all edify one another with our songs and take in Scott's lesson, that we might be built up. And it's in Jesus' name we pray.
Song number 36. Good evening, saints. Well, that projector is just annoying, isn't it? Wasn't doing that this morning, was it? Tell it to stop, Dave. Oh. Yeah, the parking lot light is blinking on and off as well. Out. That's probably what it is. My apologies. We'll get Mike to fix the light in the parking lot, and that'll fix our projector. Yeah, it was doing it this morning, but not as bad. This evening, it's really bad. I don't know what the light was doing this morning, but is it blinking? I'm gonna guess though, if it's flashing on and off, it's gonna be providing a nice surge or drop of power, and that's gonna affect our projector. So. Well, this is supposed to be a song service. I do want to read some scripture. But after that, I'm going to lead some songs. And I'd like you guys to pick some out for me. Of course, remember, I don't know all the songs like Bill does. So. I want to read to you from 1 Corinthians chapter 10. In verse 1 of 1 Corinthians chapter 10, Paul writes this. He says, I want you to know, brethren, that our fathers were all under the cloud and all passed through the sea, and all were baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea, and all ate the same spiritual food, and all drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank from the spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was Christ. Nevertheless, with most of them God was not pleased, for they were overthrown in the wilderness. Now, of course, this all ties in with the lessons that I've been giving to you Sunday morning. But this imagery that Paul uses here in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, where he talks about the baptism into Moses. They were baptized into Moses. Paul gives us the picture of baptism. You've got the sea, and if you recall the histories back in Exodus chapter 14, you have the sea that's separated, and so you have a wall of water on your left and a wall of water on your right, and on top of them is a cloud. Here's something interesting for you. What is a cloud made of? Water vapor, right? How long did it take scientists to figure that out? And Moses knew it. That a cloud is water, right? But you have a picture of the people of Israel. Water on their left, water on their right, water up above. Meaning they are totally immersed in water. As they travel through the Red Sea. This is their baptism. This is what Paul tells us. This is their baptism, baptized into Moses in the cloud. And in the sea. These people were baptized into Moses. And that's what a baptism looks like. It's completely covered with water. I say that because, of course, we talk about baptism quite continuously, and we need to, because the world is not only set against baptism, but it is twisted and distorted baptism. And Paul's picture here in 1 Corinthians is the same as he uses in Romans chapter 6, and it's the same that we find in the book of Acts, and it's the same that we find in all the Gospels. Baptism is an immersion into water. Here we find they're completely surrounded baptized into Moses. And those Israelites baptized into Moses, they all ate the same spiritual food, didn't they? That's what Paul says here. They all drank the same spiritual drink. They drank from the rock that followed them. That rock was Christ. That did not guarantee their salvation. They're baptized. They got spiritual food. They got spiritual drink. But verse 5, nevertheless, with most of them, God was not pleased, for they were overthrown in the wilderness. I covered that this morning. They didn't make it. Baptism is not a guarantee of salvation. Consumption of spiritual food and spiritual drink is not a guarantee of salvation. What can we do to make sure that we do not follow in their example? Verse 6, Paul continues, now these things took place as examples for us, that we might not desire evil as they did. Do not be idolaters, as some of them were. As it is written, the people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to play. We just looked at that Wednesday night, didn't we? Verse 8, we must not indulge in sexual immorality as some of them did, and 23,000 fell in a single day. We must not put Christ to the test as some of them did, and were destroyed by serpents, nor grumble as some of them did, and were destroyed by the destroyer. Now these things happened to them, and it's an example. But they were written down for our instruction, on whom the end of the ages has come. Therefore, let anyone who thinks that he stands take heed lest he fall. And when Paul talks about falling here, he's not talking about, oh, I tripped and stumbled. Go back and read verse 5 again. Nevertheless, with most of them, God was not pleased, for they were overthrown in the wilderness. If you recall what I read this morning, when God told them that they would die in the wilderness, he didn't say you would just die. He said your bodies would fall in the wilderness, didn't he? Returning to verse 12, therefore let anyone who thinks that he stands take heed lest he fall. No temptation has overtaken you that is not common to man. God is faithful, and he will not let you be tempted beyond your ability. But with the temptation, he will also provide the way of escape that you may be able to endure it. I would hope, the lesson that we should understand there, that we can endure the temptation, that we should escape. And it's not just enduring as in going through the temptation, but enduring as in continuing to live with God, with Christ. He has provided us that way, that means, that escape. The only question is, will we take it? There's your scripture reading for you this evening. Something for you to think about. 653, Dave, if you would. I didn't notice, but I think the entire time I was speaking, our projector did not wig out. Now would be the time for it to do that, right? 653 in your songbook.
I must needs go home by the way of the cross. There's no other way but this. I shall never get inside of the gates of life if the way of the cross I miss. The way Oh.
When my love to Christ grows weak, 752.
When my love to Christ grows weak, when for
I don't think so. I don't know. 288. I need you every hour. As I said, I read it as I was running out the door, so. This one, but I've never left this, so unless Bill wants to lead it, I'll have to pass. Thank you. Please do. 700.
To the word, we are servants of God. Let us follow the path that our Master has trod. With the balm of his counsel, our strength to renew, let us do with our mind what our hands find to do. Toiling on, toiling on, toiling on, toiling on. blessed Redeemer, this is my constant longing and prayer. Gladly I'll forfeit all of earth's treasures, Jesus at birth, likeness to wear. Blessed Redeemer.
home. So Gentry's going to lead us in our invitation song, closing song. Thank you guys so much for coming out this evening. If you need our prayers, our support, we're here to do that, to love on one another at a distance, right? At a distance. Gail has a sign-up sheet for those that are planning to go to the picnic in Alpena. The sooner you sign up, the sooner other congregations know how much they need to get supplies for. Because, as an example, Alpena is providing the main course. They're providing the paper supplies. So there's a big difference between 20 people showing up and 30 people showing up if you only have 25 plates. Gets a little uncomfortable holding hot fried chicken in your hands with no plate. I don't know if they got fried chicken or not, but I like fried chicken. So, but Gail's got the sign-up sheet. Make sure you put on there who you are, how many are going, and if you know what dish you're going to be bringing, put that on there as well. Or if you're going to be bringing drinks. That way we don't all show up with side dishes and no drinks. That would be bad, right? So that sign-up sheet, I assume, will be in the foyer after tonight. Make sure you sign up for that. And that is June 27th. I will make something on Facebook to remind us all that use Facebook when that's coming. So make sure you look for that event on Facebook. And I think that's all I've got. So if you need prayers, man, does our world need prayers right now? The U.S., oh my goodness. Just a reminder, we've got our food bank. So if you got neighbors that need food, or if you need food, let me know, give me a call. And we got plenty of food, so we'd love to share it. Yeah, lots of beans. And there's lots of frozen chicken too. I got a freezer full of literally freezer full of chicken. So all right. Gentry's going to lead us in our closing song. Let's go ahead and stand and sing. Who's got closing prayer? Bill does? All right. Gentry, lead us.
Gather in safety.
praise you and to approach your throne of grace and prayer. Father, we are mindful of those that are lawbreakers. We understand that as American citizens we have a right to protest, but that right to protest does not include the destruction of property or endangering the lives of others. It's our prayer that these people, Father, might think if they could just maybe put their stuff on the other side rather than seeking their way, what they want. Father, it's difficult. Oftentimes it's difficult for us to try to put ourselves in the place of others. But you did. As Jesus came into the world to live among us, he put himself in our place. He tempted in all points as we are, and yet he resisted the temptation. He was true to you. He is our example. Father, we would pray that others might look at him and not just think of a religious figure, but really to see him as he truly is as God. To understand more deeply the love that you have for all people. That you're concerned for everyone. As we have opportunity, Father, may we help others to come to know you, to appreciate you, and even to love you, hopefully, as we love you, and desire to be pleasing in your sight, and useful in your service. We pray that you go with us to our homes and abide with us and watch over us. It's in Jesus' name.